Greetings. Thank you, Brother Zahur, for your interesting list of surprising claims. One of your claims is short enough to quickly address. Is the name of Jesus mentioned Old Testament Bible? If you want us to prove name of Muhammad in Bible, why do you think Christians want you to prove Muhammad is named in the Bible? Maybe this is the first question you really need to understand, brother. There is in fact a reason which no honest man can ignore. Don't you know, brother, that Muhammad claimed he was mentioned? And if Muhammad claimed he was mentioned, Muhammad must prove his claim. If Muhammad cannot prove his claim, he has judged himself. Muhammad has condemned himself as a dishonest man, a liar. You may ask, how has Muhammad condemned himself? By his own example and his own words. Surah 2, 111, and they say, none will enter paradise except one who is a Jew or a Christian. That is merely their wishful thinking. Say, produce your proof if you be truthful. Some say, if you be honest. So Muhammad's example is to demand someone produce their proof, or else call them dishonest. And you will probably want to claim I took that one scripture alone out of context. But Muhammad used this dodge more than once. Surah 27:64. Is he not best who begins creation and then repeats it, and who provides for you from the heaven and earth? Is there a deity with Allah? Say, produce your proof if you should be truthful, or if you are honest. Again, brother, Muhammad's technique and strategy is to demand someone produce their proof, or else imply they are dishonest. Produce your proof if you are honest. If you do not produce your proof, you have no proof, and therefore you are dishonest. I hope you are able to understand Muhammad's own logic, brother. And Muhammad never produced any proof. The only conclusion is that Muhammad condemns himself as dishonest. Your question, brother, is backwards, just like Muhammad's strategy. Is the name of Jesus mentioned Old Testament Bible? If you want us to prove name of Muhammad in Bible, you try to change the topic from Muhammad's lie altogether. Is the name of Jesus mentioned Old Testament Bible? If you want us to prove name of Muhammad in Bible, this is your way to try and reverse the demand and run from Muhammad's lie. Before you will address Muhammad's lie, you think Christians must pass your imaginary test. But that is a game for fools, brother. Fools to make and fools to be controlled by. I'll let you think about that for a while, brother. Maybe you think enough to wonder why Muhammad never produced his proof. Maybe you'll even be honest enough yourself to judge Muhammad by his own words. But there is a bigger issue here that you and Islam ignore, brother. Credentials. Credentials. Muhammad needed them, did not have them, had to make them, create them, invent them, steal them. If you need to make fake dollars, you must make them look like real dollars. If you need the credentials of a prophet, you take them from the source of real credentials, real prophets, the Torah and Bible. Think about that, brother. Muhammad tried to take and make his credentials from the only real source of credentials from God, the Torah and Bible, thus proving that the Torah and Bible of Muhammad's day were still the only word of God in the earth, as they remain to this very day. It is Islam, brother, which desperately tries to insert Muhammad into the Word of God, the Bible. Islam makes this claim over and over, brother. DDAT, Nike, The Dean Show. And like Muhammad, I just say, produce your proof if you are honest. To this very day, no one in Islam has produced one atom of evidence, which according to Muhammad means they are all dishonest, brother. Islam is dishonest. I suppose you can try and take up the challenge, brother. Produce book and chapter and verse from the Torah and Bible which mentions an unlearned prophet who cannot read nor write. If you cannot, you might just want to take Muhammad at his word. If Muhammad cannot produce proof to support his claim, he and his claim are not honest. And your game to dodge Muhammad's lies don't work any better here than Muhammad's lies themselves. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.